בהמה, בצער רב וביגון עמוק, על מותו של ראש הממשלה ושר הביטחון יצחק רבין, אשר נרצח בידי מתנקש הערב בתל אביב. יהי זכרו ברוך.
The state of Israel is stunned, shattered. Our hearts refuse to believe. A young Israeli, one of our own, has assassinated the Prime Minister of Israel, Yitzhak Rabin. It happened at the largest public plaza in Tel Aviv, Malchei Yisrael Square. Just moments ago, the mass rally for peace and against violence ended. Yitzhak Rabin left the stage and began moving toward his car, and the assassin aimed his gun at his exposed back, and with three gunshots, ended his life.
I, military ID number 30743, retired general in the Israel Defense Forces in the past, consider myself to be a soldier in the army of peace today. I, who served my country for 27 years as a soldier, I say to you, today we are embarking on a battle which has no dead and no wounded, no blood and no anguish. This is the only battle which is a pleasure to wage, the battle for peace.
These words were uttered only a few months before his assassination by a man who spent most of his life in the military, a fighter, a soldier, a general. In the Palmach during the War of Independence and as the chief of staff of the Israel Defense Forces, during the Six-Day War in which Israel defeated the armies of Egypt, Jordan, and Syria, conquered Sinai and the Golan Heights, Judea and Samaria, and reunified Jerusalem. Yitzhak Rabin was born in Jerusalem and was educated at the Kaduri Agricultural School in the Galilee. There, even before Israel became a state, he began his life as a soldier, enlisting in the Palmach.
At an age that most youngsters are struggling to unravel the secrets of mathematics and the mysteries of the Bible, at an age when first love blooms, at the tender age of 16, I was handed a rifle so that I could defend myself. That was not my dream.
The War of Independence broke out. As a commander, Yitzhak Rabin took part in the intense battles to keep open the road to Jerusalem. Fighting with Palmach units, he conquered the Negev and northern Sinai. 20 years later, 1967, Chief of Staff Yitzhak Rabin leads the IDF as it conquers the Sinai Peninsula, the Golan Heights, Judea, and Samaria. At Jerusalem's Western Wall, the soldiers shower their love and affection on the chief of staff who reunified the divided city. During the 1970s, as Israel's prime minister, Yitzhak Rabin must contend with Palestinian terrorism that stalks Israel from within. He vehemently declares, "We will meet the Palestinian enemy only on the battlefield."
בוצע הלילה כאן מעשה רצח נתעב. הוא חושף את התמונה האמיתית של כוונתם, מחזק ומבסס את ההחלטה הנחושה של ישראל. עם המרצחים בשום פנים לא נדבר, איתם ניפגש אך ורק בשדה הקרב.
1987, Intifada, the Palestinian uprising against Israeli rule. Yitzhak Rabin, as defense minister, orders the IDF to put down the uprising by force.
אם רצוננו להיות, להתקיים כמדינה, להגיע לשלום,
יש להגיב בכוח המתאים לכל אחת מצורות הפעולה האלימה כנגדנו.
The Intifada carries on for years. No one can foresee when it might end. Where will all this lead us? Will Israel continue to rule over millions of Arabs? This is when Yitzhak Rabin's diplomatic worldview reached its turning point. The realization sets in that a solution to the conflict is not on the battlefield.
With you, we are in confrontation. Let's shift the confrontation to negotiation. Let's solve it not by using stones, petrol bottles, knives, but around the negotiation table.
In the 1992 elections, the Labour Party, led by Yitzhak Rabin, triumphs. Back in power, he will take the big step, making peace with the Palestinians, Israel's bitterest enemies since it became a state. On September 13, 1993, Prime Minister Yitzhak Rabin signs his name to the Oslo Agreement. In exchange for peace, Israel will give up land, parts of the land of Israel that was conquered by Rabin and the IDF in 1967. Striving to advance the peace process, Yitzhak Rabin shakes hands with Arafat, the man who more than anyone else symbolizes the Palestinian enemy.
אני באתי לשבת בכיסא הזה של ראש ממשלה, לא למצוא חן בעיני X או Y או Z. אני רואה בזה מעין גולת הכותרת של חיי. אני מרגיש שאני חי בתקופה ייחודית. יש סיכוי למצות באמת שינוי במערכת היחסים בינינו ובין העולם הערבי, בינינו ובין הארצות השכנות והפלסטינים.
But the path to peace is long and hard and is lined with obstacles. Hamas, which opposes Yasser Arafat and the peace process, carries out a series of murderous terrorist attacks. Buses filled with passengers are blown up. Car bombs explode in city centers, sowing death and destruction. On the Israeli side as well, there are those who oppose the historic compromise and the peace process. They hold demonstrations that are filled with hatred and violence, and they direct all their rage at Yitzhak Rabin.
אני רוצה מדינת ישראל כמדינה יהודית ולא מדינה דו-לאומית. דורות של יהודים ב-2000 השנים האחרונות בחלומותיהם, בתפילותיהם, על שיבת ציון, לא חלמו על מדינה דו-לאומית, אלא על מדינה יהודית, גם לא בכל ארץ ישראל.
The peace process moves forward. The peace treaty with Jordan, widely supported by the Israeli public, is signed in the Arava desert.
To the mother of the Jordanian newborn, a blessed day to you. To the mother of the Israeli newborn, a blessed day to you. The peace that was born today gives us all the hope that the children born today will never know war between us, and their mothers will know no sorrow.
With Yasser Arafat's arrival in Gaza as part of the peace agreement, the atmosphere of incitement against Yitzhak Rabin heats up. In posters, he appears as an SS officer. Extremist rabbis brand him guilty of sacrificing Jewish lives, a crime that can only mean one thing, a sentence of death. Rabin is not deterred. He continues the peace process. Visiting the scenes of terrorist bombings, he does not pay adequate attention to the threats on his life. On Saturday night, November 4th, 1995, the masses gathered at a public square in Tel Aviv to demonstrate their support for peace and protest the increase in violence among the Israeli public.
Erev Tov, Shavua Tov. תרשו לי לומר שאני גם מתרגש. אני רוצה להודות לכל אחת ואחד מכם שהתייצב כאן כנגד האלימות ובעד השלום.
The rally ended with Shir HaShalom, the song of peace. Yitzhak Rabin placed the page with the words of the song in his pocket and left the stage. At the foot of the steps, the assassin was waiting for him.
אנחנו במהדורת חדשות מיוחדת בכיכר מלכי ישראל היו יריות לפני שעה קלה. עד כה ידוע שראש הממשלה נפגע ופונה לבית החולים איכילוב בתל אביב. מצבו של ראש הממשלה מוגדר קשה מאוד.
אי אפשר לעכל את זה. זה לא... בן אדם תורם את החיים שלו. מקום המדינה הוא מלווה אותנו ו... עושה משהו ש... עושים את זה בבת אחת, בשנייה עושים הכל.
עכשיו אין לנו אבא.
את פוחדת?
בוודאי. פשוט מזועזעת. יש לו מאמינה שדבר כזה יכול לקרות.
Yitzhak Rabin was my partner and my friend. I admired him and I loved him very much. Because words cannot express my true feelings, let me just say, Shalom, Haver. Goodbye, friend.
אל הנמס ועד קרבות חותרת ספינתך זרי פרחים בהמונים המון אדם צוהל כאשר ספינת הקרב
Hundreds of thousands of mourners came to Jerusalem to say their goodbyes to Yitzhak Rabin.
בלית ברירה אני נפרדת ממך גיבור ומבקשת ממך שתנוח על משכבך בשלום ושתחשוב ותתגעגע אלינו כי אנחנו פה למטה אוהבים אותך המון משיירת מלאכי שמיים שמלווים אותך עכשיו אני מבקשת שישמרו עליך ושישמרו עליך טוב כי אתה ראוי למשמר שכזה אנחנו אוהבים אותך סבא תמיד
משמר יעבור לדום
אני הולך
עוד לך תהיה חזק למעלה.
We will remember Yitzhak Rabin, the fighter and commander who was a soldier in the army for peace. We will remember the leader who dared to take a dream and turn it into reality. We will remember the man who symbolized for us the hope, the man who paid for all these with his life.
אבל גם הם קדים אל מול אורך המשגע כשהעצובים הולכים לים לכם הים הלובה וזה עצוב שלהחזיר ציוד אפשר לא גם לנצח אחי אזכור אותך תמיד וניפגש בסוף אתה יודע ויש לי חברים אבל גם